Assalamu alaikum students, how are you? Last week I have explained you the chapter plants and today we will discuss the exercise of the lesson. If you see in your booklet, there are activities at the end of chapter number 3, naming plants. First I gave you the question answers. Question number 1 is answer the following questions. A part is where do plants grow. So as I have explained in the lesson that plants grow in different kinds of places, like some plants grow in dry places, some plants grow in wet places, some plants grow in desert. So you can write the answer that plants grow in different kinds of places. B part is what do plants need to make their food. You know that plants need air, water, and sunlight and chlorophyll to make their food. So you can write they need air, water, sunlight and chlorophyll to make their food. Third C part is how do plants without seeds make new plants. So the answer would be that these type of plants have small brown spots on their leaves. Each spot has a brown powder of tiny spores. So when these spores fall on ground, they change into a plant or there a new plant grows. So answer would be that these type of plants have small brown spots on their leaves. Each spot has a brown powder of tiny spores. When these spores fall on the ground, they change into a plant or there a new plant grows. D part is where are the seeds made in seed bearing plants. So the answer would be in seed bearing plants, seeds are made inside the flower. Though in those plants where the seeds, there are seeds, the seeds are made inside the flower. So the answer is in seed bearing plants, seeds are made inside the flower. E part is how does a mushroom get food. So the mushrooms don't have green color, so no chlorophyll in it, and they get their food from the humus. Mushrooms get their food from the humus in the soil. What is humus? Humus is a mixture of dead leaves and small animals. So mushrooms get their food from the humus in the soil. F part is what are the two kinds of cones made by a pine tree. So they have pine trees have two kinds of cones. There are pollen cones which contain pollens and there are seed cones which make seeds. Pine tree has two kinds of cones, pollen cones and seed cones which make seeds. Next question is fill in the blanks to show how a flower makes seeds. A is when a dash lands on a flower, the yellow powder called dash stick to its body. So in first you will write when a bee lands on a flower, the yellow powder called pollen stick to its body. When it flies to another flower, the pollen sticks to the sticky tip of the carpel. B part is a dash grows from the pollen. A tube grows from the pollen. It goes into an ovule in the ovary. The ovule grows into a seed. The ovary grows big and makes the fruit. This is all I have explained in the lesson with the topic how a flower makes seed. If you see In your booklet on page number 78, I have explained the topic with the title How a Flower Makes Seed. In this way you will fill the blanks. Next is label the parts of the flower. If you see in your booklet on page number 79, there is a parts of a flower, and I have explained this with the help of a diagram. So in your booklet, in the exercise on page number 81, there is a question, label the parts of the flower. So you will label the parts of the flower. First you see there are two parts having names A and B. These two parts make the part of a flower called stamen. Similarly, C and D make the carpel. E part is colored leaves, are the colored part of the flower, and these are called petals. Below the petals there are green leaves which are not labeled in the diagram, and they are sepals. So A and B are stamen, C and D make the carpel, and the colored part E is the that colored part, and its name is petal. And below petals there are green leaves which are called sepals. Now the last question is, put a tick in the correct column. There are some fruits given in this question. Name of the fruit are orange, plum, groundnut, peanut, bean, tomato, coconut and apple. You have to separate the fresh, soft and fleshy fruits and dry fruits. Now orange is a soft and fleshy fruit. Plum is also soft and fleshy. Groundnut is dry. Peanut is dry. Bean is also dry. Tomato is soft and fleshy. Coconut is also soft and not so soft, but in fresh form it is fleshy, but you will write it in dry. And apple is also soft and fleshy. This is all about the exercise of the lesson. So inshallah, next week I will explain the next chapter, matter, given in your booklet on page number 82. You have to solve this book, do the exercise and solve all the questions in your booklet, and try to do it in your notebook too.